Hey internet, and welcome back to another Talking Points video. If you don't know me already, my name is Mark and I'm a student at college, and today I wanted to make a pretty short video, but it's about a topic that's pretty important to me. And that is just meeting friends that you've made online in the real world. Since everyone and everything has been so remote for the past 16 or 17 months now, it's a topic that I wanted to bring up. During my spring 2020 semester, I was in Paris and I made a conscious effort to say, hey Mark, be more social this semester. Try and actively make more friends. Not that many people, no one else probably knows each other, so get in there and just try and talk to some people. It was going pretty well, and then the pandemic hit around March, so my mission got cut short. However, since then, in the past 2.5 semesters or so, I've made more friends over Zoom, DMs, and Discord than I would have ever expected to. Now, I've just moved back to the city recently, which is why my setup is different. I've got a horrible shadow in the background. I just haven't figured out my full setup yet. And I've made a lot of plans to meet some of these aforementioned online friends in the city. And I've recently met up with quite a few and plan to meet up with many more in the near and far future. For me, however, meeting up with online friends in the real world is not some new phenomenon, and there are a lot of similarities I've noticed in these past week and a half, I suppose, and years ago when I first met online friends that I wanted to talk about. However, this phenomenon, I should say, of meeting people in real life for the first time after having conversations with them online is not new to me, and there's a lot of thoughts and emotions, I suppose, that have come up in the past week or so of meeting people from school that have been similar to people I've met prior to this, and I wanted to talk about that phenomenon and end the video with a bit of a pay it forward message. Taking several steps back, I made a lot of friends through games like Minecraft or general stuff like that and Discord when it first came around, and I have spoken to a lot of them on Skype when that was like the main form of communication, and just a very small handful of them I've met in person. For example, one of my good friends who lives in London, I had known for about 4 or 5 years before when I went with my dad to see some family for Christmas a couple years ago, I was like, hey, I should try meeting this person. Then when he came to New York after that, he was like, hey man, let's get together again. My parents were definitely skeptical, of course, but quite frankly, if someone has the patience and the persistence to pull off a 6-year catfish, the best way I was able to explain it to my parents was like meeting an old high school friend after several years of knowing them. I'm not really old enough to actually know that feeling, but that's the best way I could explain it, and it still feels true today. When you meet these people in real life, you can finally put a face, a voice, or even just a name to connect to some physical entity in the real world, and the feeling of meeting someone for the first time disappears within the first minute because you already have all these conversations and experiences and memories to fall back on that you've already had together. Now, these are observations that I made from meeting these previous online friends, and only 3 or 4 of them. But in the past week or so of meeting people from Zoom University, I've had the same experiences and same observations. Within 48 hours of being here, I met up with a few people from the computer science Discord that I'm a part of. The day after that, I met up with one of the same people and someone else at the gym facility that NYU has, and we got dinner afterward. And the day after that, I got coffee with someone who I didn't really know all that well, but we still had a great conversation and got along really well. From this tier of I've had really good banter with this person to we pretty much discussed a project and had the same class together, it's still really easy to fall into conversation with people even though I've never really met them before. As the introvert I am, I'm feeling uncomfortable trying to organize all these things, but I'm already looking forward to meeting more people tomorrow, this weekend, next week, and 2 or 3 weeks out. Quite frankly, it's the most social I've been in a very long time. I was sort of a recluse in high school outside of classes when I would get home and whatnot. In my first year of college, I didn't try very hard to make friends, and when I did try, the pandemic was like, no. With only one semester left, I want to take people up on the offer to get coffee sometime. I want to be able to reach out to someone even if the conversations we might have had were really brief. I've missed out on a lot of time, so I'm trying to make up for that and really put effort into this. Again, it's pretty uncomfortable. As an introvert, asking someone, hey, do you still want to go get coffee sometime? I'm in the city, is weird and uncomfortable. I don't even drink coffee. It feels like I'm going out of my skin to meet people and do things that I've never intentionally done before, but that's why it's so valuable. When I was a freshman, I started a journal, and that's now 160 pages or so long, single-spaced, But reading the first few entries, I was incredibly lonely. The first welcome week of being at university was kind of like, eh, it was fun and all, but I didn't meet many people, and I'd written about, you know, how I missed the past and whatnot. So the message that I would give to that self is this one here. I really don't know why in the past I didn't try and walk up to more people and be like, hey, we have a class together. Some people walk up to me and I was a pretty good conversationalist and I would try to engage with people, but I never put in an active effort, not even remotely close to what I'm doing now. The loneliness persisted, and while it's good in a lot of ways to learn how to be alone with yourself, isolation is something that you can fight even though it might be something that you're uncomfortable with. I don't really know why I never tried to go up to someone in a class and try and strike up a conversation. A few people had done so to me, and I've made few really good friends that way that I've maintained connections with, but I want to be the one now to make that active effort. How I'll reach out to people I don't consistently speak with, how I will fight that voice in my head that says, nah, they don't want to hang out again, that was a one-time thing. However, I've taken the first step, and that's just giving it a shot. The worst thing that can happen is someone says, no, I don't want to hang out. That's the worst possible situation, and as you do this more and more, even if people do say no, you become more comfortable with it. You become more accepting of rejection. Now, I encourage you to take this first step as well. Definitely be safe if you're on the internet, but specifically in an academic environment, if you're going to the same school as someone, make that active effort to say, hey, after class or, you know, some mutual thing, let's get coffee or whatever it might be. What I've been telling myself is to not worry about what comes next. Just focus on step one and take it from there. Anyway, that's all for today. I'm not sure what video will be next week, but there will be one. There will be no horrible shadow like this in the background. And perhaps it won't just be me talking at the camera with the occasional B-roll. I do want to put more effort into things. This is a topic I feel pretty adamant about. And I just wanted to bring it up because people you meet online that you make connections with online are also real people. And if you have the opportunity to meet them in person, that connection can become even stronger. So yeah, thanks for watching, have a good one. Don't forget to step out of your comfort zone whenever you can, just don't go too far. But as always, don't forget to stay awesome. See you next week.